Morning, child.
Morning, father.
Your eyes are a gift from your mother, like this box.
Thank you.
Beadle, no man unworthy shall set foot in this house. If you wish to have words, then have him send a letter and come to court. No filth shall set foot in this house.
My lord, he does have a proposal for you about your dear Iris.
She is too young. No man shall have her hand until her 16th birthday.
There are cruel men in this world, my lord. You wouldn't want her to marry an abusive man.
Correct, and she shall not leave this house.
But my lord, you can't deny her her prayer.
I'm not denying her her prayer. I'm denying her social events. I shall arrange for a priest to come and hear her confessions. The lord shall hear her prayers, no matter where she is. Do you feel I should be stricter?
Stricter, my lord. Stricter than not letting her leave the house. Beat! You don't mean to beat her, my lord!
If necessary, a firm hand will do her no harm. Walk with me.
You speak as if you have a wayward son, my lord. No daughter should feel the hand of brutal punishment.
She is not wayward. She is confused. I shall cure this confusion with hand and tongue.
Yes, my lord, but Isabella would be displeased if you punished her today.
Yes, if Isabella saw me strike her today, she would have me in my grave.
With the Bible in her hand, into bed I did creep, to read a few chapters before going to sleep. As my eyelids grew heavy, I heard a faint sound. I held on to the good book and turned around. He stared at me with two piercing eyes. He said, "Put down the book, stop reading those lies. My master has sent me to get rid of this lark. I am an agent of Lucifer, the Prince of the Dark. I see you are reading in Genesis and Acts. More of God's ramblings, now hear the facts. Adam and Eve are a myth, they are God's fairy tale. Your ancestors were not human, you once had a tail. I will infiltrate your churches and set up the stage, to replace the old time religion with mine, the new age. Forget God's commandments, put your mind at ease. You can form your own destiny and do as you please. I'll fill up the book with sex, language and gore, until it seems like the norm, and the people want more. Then I'll bring it in all your streets and scream to thee, daytime and prime time, so the children can see. Stop and listen, good people, he is calling to you, to put off the old and to put on the new. To bring Jesus in your life and be freed of Satan's snare, to say the following words from this simple prayer. Lord Jesus, come into my heart, wash away my sins, give me a new start. You are the Son of the living God, I give my life to you. Fill me with your presence, with a spirit that's new. That's all it takes to bring Jesus in your life, to get rid of Satan's yoke and all of the strife. If you say this with meaning, then his presence you'll feel. The Holy Spirit will be there, and you'll be under his seal.
Yes, my lord, but why would she speak to me?
Because she trusts you more than she trusts me.
Okay, I will do it, my lord.
Thank you. I'll be in my study.
Okay. Iris, where are you? Your father has bequeathed me to speak with you. Oh. Iris, where are you? Your father has sent me to speak with you. Oh my goodness, where could she be? Could she be through the gap in between the trees? I don't know. I've got to find her or he'll have my head. Yes, Iris. Your father has sent me to speak with you.
My father? Why?
He believes you are troubled.
Troubled? No. Just feeling a little strange.
A little strange?
Yes. Ever since he bought me that book for my birthday.
A book? Which one?
Wonders of Tonight. It's by an unknown author.
How cute.
Yes. It's given me inspiration to write.
To write? What on earth about?
About magical creatures living in this magical forest. The one I read about in the book.
Magical creatures?
Yes, like unicorns, dragons, mermaids. The list goes on and on.
Mermaids.
I didn't even read any of them before this book. And now it's given me a sense of power.
Power?
Yes. Weird things have been happening.
Such as?
Such as I can't control my emotions properly anymore. I'm feeling stronger.
Stronger?
Yes. Don't tell Father this. But my desk in my room's broken. I slammed down my ink one night.
Why on earth did you do that?
I don't know, I got angry.
Angry? Angry with what?
I don't have a clue at all. It was just a sense came over me. Like I had to be angry.
A sense?
Yes. A sense. But from what I don't know. Please don't tell
the scientist. I won't. I'll just have to fix something.
Thank you. You put me in a grave.
Yes, that's what I feel. My lord, I have news. I have news of what Iris thinks.
Tell me.
She's reading a book. A book she said you gave her. That was handwritten by an author unknown.
That's impossible.
She was saying it's a wonderful world of magical creatures and it's inspired her to write.
Nonsense. Magic does not exist.
I know that as well as you. But... thoughts inside her head were just getting stronger and stronger.
All right. told you I've not been praying.
There's nothing to pray for.
You will pray now.
No.
Pray, child.
No.
Do not defy me.
Dear Judge Brown, I'm deeply sorry to inform you that on the account of your daughter's recent behaviour, God has only given you two choices. She must pray in forgiveness of the soul, pray for the innocence of her young mind, and the protection of the Lord. That is, if Satan hasn't tainted her mind properly. Since my recent visits, the child has refused prayer and sent me away. If this proceeds any further, I'm sorry to pronounce that she must be sent for judgment by our Lord. Priest Johnson.
My Lord, I have something I really need to say.
Tell me then.
Okay. It's just, it's really complicated to pray.
Just say it.
I love Iris.
We have had this conversation about her love life. No man shall have her until she is 16. Do you understand?
But...
Get off these grounds now!
Father? What's wrong?
I'm going to tell your mother.
She was the beauty of my world. She was the colour to my sight. I now see in black and white. Your mother used to make me smile. She loved these gardens. She loved nature. She would sing to the birds, and what a lovely voice she had. It made the flowers bloom and my heart blossom. Then, the day she died, you were born. I felt like my world was destroyed, but I had you, the record of my life, your mother. Eyes, your everything. All these years, I still refuse to let her go. You must understand, I cannot live out here. Brown, I'm sorry for my intrusion on Iris' love life, my lord. I love your daughter, but wish not to be without work. I write this letter in proposal of my previous position in your courts, and wish to be reunited. Under circumstances that I shall not have any contact with Iris, physically or verbally. Beadle Daniel Thomas.
Private business.
It must be done.